This is the new Pironman 5 NAS case for a Raspberry Pi 5. It's the latest addition to SunFounder's Pironman series, and this one's all about turning your Pi into a compact and capable NAS. This case comes with dual drive bays that can take either 2.5-inch or full 3.5-inch size drives, giving you plenty of flexibility. It also includes some other nice extras, like a 2.5GB network adapter, a large 90mm cooling fan, and an OLED stats display on the front. This is still a beta product. SunFounder are in their internal testing phase, and these haven't gone into full production yet, so some of the things shown in this video may change before the official launch later this year. Keep that in mind as we go through the build. Inside the box, we've got the assembly instructions right on top. Under that, there's another white box protected by foam padding, which is good considering the condition that the outer box arrived in. This holds the enclosure and a collection of accessory packs with all of the panels, components, and PCBs. Like with their other Pironman cases, they've included quite a lot with this NAS kit. We've got the aluminium housing, the acrylic panels and large 90mm fan, a universal 12V 4A power supply, a few adapter and control PCBs, as well as heat sinks for the Pi, and then an OLED display, cables, screws and other mounting hardware. Also, as usual with SunFounder kits, they include basic tools that you need to assemble the case, and all of the screws are neatly and clearly labeled. Assembling the case is straightforward thanks to their picture guided instruction sheet. The acrylic panels even have countersunk screw holes, which will give the finished build a cleaner look. We start off by adding standoffs to one of the acrylic panels. This is where the Pi assembly is going to be mounted. Next we need our Raspberry Pi, and then plug in the adapter boards and mount the stack onto the base standoffs. That's then secured with a range of additional standoffs and screws. Then we install the 5 heatsinks on the Pi's heat generating components. The CPU heatsink looks like it's a little on the small side, but we'll see how it performs later on in stress testing. Next, the main SATA and control hat goes onto the Pi. This is also held in place with some screws. The OLED display neatly plugs into the 4-pin socket on the board. Before installing the base in the housing, we need to also plug in the fan. The whole Pi assembly is then mounted onto the bottom of the aluminium housing and is held in place with 4 screws. Some rubber feet finish off the base. Acrylic panels are then screwed onto the 3 sides of the enclosure to cover up the Pi bay. The fan gets mounted onto the final acrylic cover plate for the top of the enclosure. The NAS enclosure is quite cleverly designed. It can house either 2 3.5-inch drives, which are secured with screws on both sides, or 2 2.5-inch drives secured by screws on just one side. I'm going to install a set of 1TB Crucial BX500 solid-state drives for testing. I would have liked to have seen a 4-bay option for only 2.5-inch drives, but with options like the Radsa Penta SATA hat, it makes sense to go for this gap in the market for 3.5-inch drives. These are still popular for high capacity NAS builds, as they're significantly cheaper than similarly sized SSDs. We can then close up the top cover. And that's the NAS assembled. The fully assembled NAS measures 109 by 109 by 216mm high. This is quite a compact footprint, considering it could be housing 2 full-size 3.5-inch drives. Now's probably a good time to explain the I.O. that this kit provides. On the right side, we've got the Pi's existing gigabit Ethernet port, 2 USB 3 ports, and 2 USB 2 ports. Above those is a small slot to pass through a ribbon cable for the camera or display ports on the Pi. Alongside that, the adapter provides 2 full-size HDMI ports. Then above those, we've got the 12V barrel jack input, then the adapted full set of GPIO pins, and a unique feature of this enclosure is the addition of a 2.5GB network port. Let's get it booted up and do some testing on it. SunFounder's recommendation is to run OpenMediaVault or OMV. So we need to flash Raspberry Pi OS Lite onto a microSD card and then plug this into the slot on the front of the case. We then run through a few steps to update the Pi, install OMV, and then install the Pironman script to drive the OLED display. Like with other Pironman cases, this one also has a nice web dashboard, which also allows you to see system stats and adjust settings like those for the display. The display has a few different options too. You can choose from one of these layouts or cycle between any combination of them. We can then head to the OMV web dashboard by going to the part's IP address in a browser on a computer on the same network. We'll need to set up OMV by creating a file system and then a shared folder, and we then need to create an SMB share to be able to access it on a Windows computer. With all of that done, our NAS is now ready to use, and we can map the drive to our PC and then run some tests on it. Using an automated tester with a 1GB file, we get writes of a little over 240MB per second and reads around 200. Stepping up to a 16GB file, we get similar writes of a little over 230MB per second and reads just under 170. I then tried a real-world test, copying a large 60GB video file to and from the NAS. For this test, I got an average write speed of around 260MB per second, with highs of nearly 280, and an average read speed also around 260MB per second, although this was far more consistent. So performance as a NAS is good, and speeds are what you'd expect from a 2.5GB network connection. With the large 90mm fan directly above the drives, the drive temperatures remained low throughout the read and write tests. The CPU temperature, however, is already a little higher than I'd expect from this level of load, so next I tried running a stress test on the Pi's CPU to test the supplied heatsink. I ran CPU burn on the Pi, which started off quite hot, already at 48 degrees at idle. This climbed rapidly up to 70 degrees in about 3 minutes, but it then stayed there for the duration of the 20-minute test. So as anticipated, the supplied CPU heatsink is a bit small for a sustained load, and it generally runs quite hot. It's okay in the NAS if all you're doing is transferring files, but if you're doing any sort of sustained RAID parity calculations or media encoding, then you'll probably want to install a better heatsink. As I said earlier, this is still a beta product, and SunFounder are using these tests and feedback to iron out problems before they go into production, so the final kit will likely have a better cooling solution. The outside of the case doesn't show much of a temperature increase, since there is a lot of space inside the enclosure, and the 90mm fan is quite generous. Results would probably vary a bit with 3.5-inch drives, as these close up a bit more of the internal volume, but there's still a lot of space for airflow around them, and the housing is aluminium, so it acts as a bit of a heatsink too. With SSDs installed, the 90mm fan is audible when the Pi is under full load, coming in at around 41 decibels. Fortunately, it's PWM controlled, so it only runs at full speed when the CPU gets hot, and when it's running below 800 RPM, it's silent. Again, if all you're doing is transferring files in a couple of minutes, you'll probably never hear the fan. You also likely wouldn't notice the fan noise if you're using it with 3.5-inch drives, since the drive noise would exceed this. Lastly, I tested power consumption. Under no load, the NAS draws just 8 watts, and under full load, this only goes up to 14 watts. These are both really low for a dual drive setup, so this is a great option for a very power efficient NAS. Again, I'd obviously expect this to be a bit higher with 3.5-inch drives, but the low power consumption of the Pi helps keep this figure quite low, and you can set up OMV to spin down the drives when they're not in use. So as with the other cases in SunFounder's Pironman range, this NAS case is a really well-built kit. You get good quality hardware, a nice set of features, and the assembly instructions are well presented. Because this is a product that's still in development, they haven't released details around pricing yet, but I think somewhere around $100 to $120 would be good value. Things might change a bit in the final version, but share your thoughts in the comment section below on what you think they should tweak or improve. They're aiming at making the product as good as possible for the Pi community, so your feedback here could help shape the final version. As I mentioned earlier, I would like to see a similar version of this NAS case that allows 4 2.5-inch drives to be installed like I've done previously, but the flexibility to use either 3.5-inch or 2.5-inch drives is a unique selling point. I can't think of any other Pi 5 based NAS enclosures that cater for 3.5-inch drives. That's also the main reason why I recently built my 4-bay version. I'll leave a link to the NAS case in the video description. Don't forget to add your comments below. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.